reckon he's gonna take me back to nature. I should walk up the hill to the observatory, but we talk about the Dodgers and what's different in Australia. The man with the loudest voice stands in the middle of a crowded intersection. He points and he yells and we all feel self-conscious, reflected reminders of our imperfection. I was born 30 years to the day after a deranged serial killer. I don't think I'm all that like him in real life, I'm just kind of a chiller. Judas stands before me in fashionable faded jeans and a fresh off the rack black t-shirt. I reflect his body language and I try to hide my stomach, my purple painted fingernails somehow always kicked up in dirt. I once had the loudest voice, stood smack bang in the middle of the conversation, till I kicked and I screamed and I got a bit mean and got ignored by an indifferent nation. I was born 100 years too late to be some kind of train hopping troubadour, traveling folk singer. So I'll just complain in my open plan kitchen while away the hours pretending not to be bitter. Lions don't concern themselves with the opinion of sheep. I don't know which animal in that metaphor is me. These kind of end of evening epiphanies happen much less when you live alone. I ate too much magic mushrooms, just wound up checking my phone. Yeah, I ate two magic mushrooms and just sat here on my phone.